you've seen?
Well, it's been a few. I had a guy once come in with a vibrator still vibrating in his butt. And my nurse comes and says to me, Dr. Bava, you need to sit down for a minute. And I said, I don't have time for this, sister. What? Spit it out. She said, no, you really need to sit down for this. And she says to me, well, I have a patient right now in room whatever. He's literally got a, you know, he's got a vibrator still vibrating up his butt.
Did you go in and say, what's buzzing?
I know, really. And I said to her, are you serious? She said, do I look like I'm joking?
Oh, my God. How did he go to work? What happened?
Well, his wife lost the string. Apparently, they come with a string. I didn't know that. Things you learn in the ER.
I didn't know that either.
Uh-huh.
Oh, my Lord.
Yeah. I had a woman once. Now, I don't understand this one. This other time, I swear, I am Dr. Sex Fairy because I've, you know, in some ways,
seen it all.
I've gone from gunshot wounds to vaginas, to penises, to, you know, something else. And back to vaginas.
You can
and
take it, boo.
And, oh, boo, you don't even know the half of it. And so this other time, you know, it's a long shift, okay? I am low on patience. I'm tired, you know. An ER is a tough place to work.
I can imagine.
And it's late night. I'm the only doctor there. And again, a nurse comes in and says to me, you know, nurses, God, I love them because they prepare me for what lies ahead, you know. So she literally sat me down and said, okay, don't shoot the messenger.
Oh, my gosh.
And that's never a good thing to start
right?
with. Okay, so I'm like, okay, now what? And she says, we have a patient in the room next door to us. And she says, she decided to take a banana and put that in her vagina. And now
why?
She's lost it. So I'm thinking to myself.
How big is a vagina?
How big is a vagina? Thank you. So sometimes I wonder if I'm evil with these thoughts. But
lost it?
So I'm like, how the hell do you lose a banana in your vagina?
I could not lose a banana in my vagina.
Like, I'm thinking to myself.
Was she like 6 feet tall?
Well, that's what I'm thinking. And I'm thinking to myself, did she use one of those little
she
baby
a
ones
right.
you know, that you get in the fancy
yeah.
stores
yes.
for $1,000 each?
Right.
So I'm like, what the hell happened to you? So anyway, I gown up. I put a face shield on because you never know what's going to come flying out
yes.
in the ER.
Oh,
so
maybe a whole fruit salad's coming out.
I'm telling you, baby. You think I'm kidding. I'm serious. You never know. You got to go fully protected. You know, PPE, you know,
okay.
rocks.
Yes.
So I put that on and I go in with my speculum and I'm like, I don't see anything.
Where the
it
heck
was
that
did that far
go?
Up?
Not quite. So I tried to look.
It?
I tried to. I know. See.
Digested
and I looked
it.
Up at her and I said, I don't see anything. So I'm now wondering, is it a psychiatric issue?
Oh.
And then she says to me, well. And then she looks confused. And I said, I don't even see a banana peel in there. She said, because I peeled it.
So it was a real banana.
She put a peeled banana up her vagina. Now, how is that going to give her any pleasure? I'm just confused.
I mean, don't know.
It just
either.
Disintegrated in there.
I'm so confused on so many levels.
Welcome to my world, darling. Welcome to my
did
world.
Did it like get
ew.
Digested in her vajazzle? Like
I
she bedazzled that.
No wonder
thing.
I couldn't find the damn thing. It had already disintegrated.
Oh my God! What an
oh
idiot!
My
so of course she couldn't find it. It was already gone.
Was she in pain?
No.
That's
she
probably
just
good for
it
her. That's probably like a good cleanse. I don't know.
That poor banana.
Welcome to my world.
What'd that banana do to her?
Child,
I know.
Please.
So yes, how do you think this whole sex fairy thing started? I realized it was a real problem in the world.
Yes,
I had men
clearly.
Coming in with the chief complaint of cannot get an erection. So I thought initially that my staff was playing a joke on me. You know, ER people, you know, we're an interesting breed. We kind of give each other a hard time sometimes. So I'm looking around to see who's laughing.
Hard time?
Yeah, funny. Fun unintended.
All the puns.
Yeah. Oh my God, I love her already. See, we
likewise.
Are a throuple. This
yes,
is great.
Yes.
So a little kinky maybe, but this works.
Yes.
So
an asexual throuple.
Asexual throuple, please, people. Okay. So so literally, you know, this thing, it started because I looked at it and I said, is someone playing a joke on me? And then I realized, no, the person was actually there because he was traumatized by this.
Aww.
And
oh,
I and it
thing.
Broke my heart.
Yeah.
And I thought to myself, what happened? To this man,
yes.
that he felt compelled to sign into an emergency department.
Aww.
And
he probably like
through,
had some hot babe and he just couldn't,
right?
You know, and go
do,
through
the
embarrassment
nasty.
Of writing that
Aww.
On an intake form.
Oh yeah,
right.
He was desperate.
And initially, Aww. I was like, ugh, you know, because you know, you got people having a stroke and a heart attack in
it,
one room,
literally.
And then you have, I can't get an erection. You say, is this man crazy? Which part of emergency in the emergency department did he miss?
Oh my
but
gosh!
But the truth of the matter is. It made me realize that there was a huge gap in our medical system.
Yes.
And I would ask them, and I would say, listen, why are you here? Why don't you go speak to your family doctor? Or do you have a urologist? Do you know what a urologist is?
Too embarrassed, maybe.
And, well, that's the thing. It's a good thing you brought up, because first, it's a matter of denial to oneself.
Oh.
And first, you deny that you have a problem.
Was he a young man?
A lot of them are younger. So you look at them, and that's the other thing I've got to remind you all, is that 20% of men in their 20s suffer from erectile dysfunction.
In their 20s?
In their 20s. Wow. Goes up 10% for every decade of life.
Is it too much digital porn?
No. It's a physical thing. I think everybody blames porn. I'm not by any means. People, don't give them more hate.